So in my reel yesterday, I was sharing the idea that when you curl your toes, it can help you to activate your pelvic floor. And there are a lot of connections between foot function and pelvic floor function, and I've been getting some questions about it, so I wanted to go into a little more detail. So if you're somebody who has a hard time thinking, I want to contract my pelvic floor muscles, and then having your pelvic floor muscles actually contract, curling your toes can be a good trick, because the nerve supply that goes down and helps you curl your toes shares a nerve root with the muscles of your pelvic floor, meaning that if you can send the message to your toes to curl your toes, you're already activating the nerves that then will go on a separate branch to your pelvic floor, but they follow along the same pathway. So when you activate one pathway and then you try to activate the other pathway, it can make it easier to find to get that spillover into your pelvic floor muscles. But it's more the kind of trick that helps you make that connection between your brain and your pelvic floor than it is super functional. Like, I'm not trying to encourage you to go around curling your toes when you pick your kid up from the floor or you're doing your workout. You don't want to get excessive toe curling. In fact, excessive toe curling when you are doing other functional activities can indicate that your core is weak, and so you're trying to kick on anything you can to grip to the floor to help give you stability. So in that case, I would say, like, watch your toe curling, and when you notice it, then you might want to try to see if you can turn up your core a little bit more and turn your toes down. So it depends on how conscious it is and what you're using it for. Like, it's good to use it to make that connection, but not so good if it's a compensation. But then we also hear a lot about connections between your foot and your pelvic floor. And this is one of them, the idea that they share a nerve root and that curling toes is affected with, or is connected with, a pelvic floor contraction. But even more than the fact that they share a nerve root, like, we want your foot to be able to adapt to the ground. This is a big idea, or a big part of the idea behind the barefoot movement, which I'm a huge fan of, spending as much time barefoot as possible, wearing shoes that aren't controlling your feet and aren't changing your interaction with the ground, because we don't want to interfere with your foot's ability to adapt to the surface that it's on and to the task that you're performing. And if you think about your foot's ability to do that, then it travels up the chain. Like, it's going to, your whole leg is going to be affected by how your foot interacts with the ground, and that's going to affect how your hip functions, and your hip and your pelvic floor are sharing muscles. So as your foot interacts with the ground in a more natural and efficient way, it also allows and encourages your hip and your pelvic floor to interact with the rest of your leg in a more efficient way, which spills over into your ab function, your spine function. Like, it's all interconnected. And if we're restricting your foot mobility, or we're trying to control the way that your foot interacts with the ground, it's going to have upstream effects on how your hip functions, your pelvic floor, your abs, your spine, etc. It all affects each other, and so that's the other connection in, why do we talk about feet and pelvic floor in the same sentence?